कृषी विपणन आणि रोगासंबंधित माहितीपूर्ण व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी कॉटन गुरु यूट्यूब चॅनल सबस्क्राइब करा आणि नवीन व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी बेल आयकॉनवर क्लिक करा.
जी चंद्रशेखर, इकॉनॉमिक ॲडवायझर IMC चेंबर अँड डायरेक्टर IMC ERTF, ही इज गोइंग टू स्पीक टू अस लाईव्ह अबाउट द इकॉनॉमिक्स ऑफ कॉटन. ही हॅज बीन अराउंड द वर्ल्ड एज अ स्पीकर, एज अ स्टुडंट, एज अ पॅशनेट ओव्हरसीअर about how cotton and agriculture is performing around the world. And we would like to have his views here during the cotton conclave. Chandrasekhar ji, are you here?
Yes, of course, very much. Let me start by complimenting Cotton Guru and Manish Daga for organizing this celebration of the World Cotton Day. This is fantastic. Manish wants me to talk about the significance of cotton in agriculture and global economy. All of us know very well, allow me to speak in English, although I can speak in Hindi, but let me, for sake of flow, let me speak in English. Cotton has a history of several millennia. As Suresh Bhai usually says, we've been growing it for 7,000 years, which means it is a naturally sustainable crop. Therefore, we don't have to discuss the sustainability of this crop. It's a cash crop. It's actually an industrial crop given its utilization, industrial application, both as a fiber and now as food. Cotton seed can be crushed into oil and feed for animals, and oil can be eaten for human consumption. Therefore, it has multifarious applications. Now, when we talk of the global economy and the Indian economy and the importance of cotton, very clearly, cotton is a very long value chain. And who are the participants in this value chain? You have the input suppliers, a large number of stakeholders, the input suppliers, the farmers, and other services relating to agronomy of the farmers. After harvest, you have the primary processors, secondary processors, then you have producers of value-added products, like say technical textiles, etc. Exporters, importers, logistic services, financial services, policy makers. I think it's a very long, long list of stakeholders which cotton enjoys, given its very unique characteristics of multiple application of this fiber and of course its other products. So cotton and products, not just fiber, but the seed and of course, even cotton waste for that matter. It generates tremendous amount of economic activity. It generates jobs, it generates incomes, it accelerates capacity utilization, it creates markets, and it creates consumption. All these are economic activities which obviously propel not only global and Indian agriculture, but also economic activity, and contribute to the GDP of the world and of course the GDP of India. Now, what is important is sustainability of cotton. Sustainability is these days a buzzword, particularly after the United Nations in 2015 September came up with the 17 sustainable development goals for the world. And my own research shows that cotton as a crop contributes to advancement of at least 10 out of 17 UN Sustainable Development Goals.
Oh.
It advances at least 10 out of 17 goals that the UN has declared, and therefore it is extremely important. A lot more research is required. I have done work on sustainability, and I'm now creating metrics, how to measure sustainability. That's called the metrics. I'm actually creating creating the measurement. Now, in India, what is important is that we need to take a very holistic view of cotton. I suspect at the moment we are not taking a holistic view of cotton. We are looking at cotton cultivation and production and farmers in one silo. You're looking at processors in another silo, exporters in a third silo, et cetera. I think the silo approach must stop. We must look at it absolutely holistically, from farm to fiber and from farm to food plate. I think that's the kind of approach that we need to take from a end-to-end perspective. Now, going forward, yes, we are the world's largest producers of cotton. We'll continue to maintain this position in the coming years. The OECD FAO report has said that at least until 2030, India will continue to be the world's number one producer of cotton. But let us not be complacent. Land constraints, water shortage, climate change. These are three significant risks, three significant challenges which can potentially create a risk for cotton. And therefore, to address these challenges, we need strategies. And also from a production and of course downstream processes perspective. From that perspective, I am actually looking at infusion of multiple technologies. And when we talk of technology, everybody thinks about genetic modification, agriculture, biotechnology. No, there are many, many more technologies that need to be infused, including of course agriculture, biotechnology. We have information technology, biotechnology, nuclear agriculture technology, satellite technology, nanotechnology, and multiple technologies which need to be brought in into cotton sector as a whole, right from input supplies till the final product that we are going to make. For multiple technologies are the way forward in my view. And the recent government initiative of creating a legal framework for contract farming is something very positive. It is going to be a win-win situation for both growers and entrepreneurs. There are ways in which the contract can be designed. There are ways and techniques in which the prices can be determined. Of course, this is not the time to go into details of that, but I just want to send out a message that it is possible for the farmers to benefit from contract farming. It is possible for the industry, user industry, to benefit from contract farming. I think it's an exciting time ahead for cotton, but let us not forget the challenges, and let us make sure that nature has been very kind to us. We have varied agroclimatic conditions, and therefore cotton is an absolutely natural and sustainable product. It is a gift of nature to India. While cotton is a gift of nature to India, let us make Indian cotton India's gift to the world market. I think that is the way forward. Good luck and God bless you all. Thank you. Unmute.
Yes, thank you, Chandrasekhar ji. Cotton is the USP of India, and with thought leaders like you, we are now on the right path to unlock the true potential of cotton and agriculture. So thanks a lot.